Marina Edgar, Director of Exhibitions and Art Market for Paint Creek Center for the Arts. And today we're at the opening for our 2015 Student and Faculty Exhibition. This is an annual event that Paint Creek hosts each year to showcase the work of our students and faculty side by side. This exhibition really shows the talent through our faculty and also the talents of our students.
I've been teaching here about 6 years. When I started here, I worked in the clay studio for a few years, and then since I'm a painter, I paint and draw, that's what I really do, so I started working my way to the drawing and painting classes. So now I teach abstract painting, I teach portrait drawing and figure drawing and adult beginning drawing. And once in a while I teach a kid's watercolor class. When people start to lose their inhibitions, especially in abstract painting, and they just start painting what they feel and they just let go is the best part. And with kids, it's seeing them build their skills, or with the adults that take adult drawing class, it's really fun to see how over the weeks their skills start building. It's great.
I've been at the Paint Creek studio for 2 semesters. They were both drawing art class for high schoolers. What I really liked about it was when we originally started with the pencil and we started there, and we worked with the very basic stuff just to remember how to do it, and I've never taken an art class besides the very basic school generic one. Then we moved into charcoal, which I really liked because even though it's really gritty and gets all over the place, especially when you decide to push up your glasses and you get a streak all over your cheek, it was always really fun because it was easier to take away than the pencil, and you could slowly add more and more layers. And I always found it easier to work with too. And then we went into the pastels, which added color into it, which is always tons of fun because I love color. Then for the second semester, I went more in depth into it, and I learned how to make it look better and make it look more realistic and less flat as an object. And I also put more items in it. I learned how not to put something very centered into the picture, but also off-center it so it puts more detail into it. So that was really fun. I really liked that. And then I had a nice teacher too who was always helpful in pointing out new hints or saying in a different way if I didn't understand the way she originally said it too.
I've been taking classes at Paint Creek at least 15 years, maybe more. It was a curiosity about art, the creative process, and just wanting to learn more about that. I think, inspired by nature. I live in a wooded area, and so I think that inspired me as well. And I also like to work with color. And so I think those two things brought about this painting.
I've actually taken 2 classes, and the first class was in January. It was a basic painting class, which included advanced students as well as beginner people. And the second class I just finished up with last week, it was the advanced concept of art making, and that had advanced and beginner people in it as well, but it dealt more so with oil and acrylic paints. And a lot of my paintings are very detail oriented, so it takes quite a bit of time for me to accomplish them, but this is an example of a painting I did. This is a lighthouse up in the UP. And one thing I like to incorporate into my paintings is depth. So as you can see, there's some depth in here with the lighthouse being back on the shoreline. It kind of draws your eye to the back of the painting, as well as the stones and rocks here in the foreground. The process I do when I paint my paintings is I like to actually draw things out initially, and then I block things down. And by blocking, I mean I just put a solid color down, and then you build upon that. So you build layers and layers upon the initial blocking, and that's how you get the detail in here. So you get the shadowing and you get the light, and you kind of have to bounce that off each other. So that's kind of how I get the detail in the rocks here, as well as the lighthouse in the background and the reflection in the water. And one of the things that I like about taking classes here is the fact that you've got instructor-led training courses, as well as students are in the course as well. And both those aspects provide feedback to you so that you can actually take that feedback and apply it to your work. These are done through periodic critiques, and the critiques provide positive and negative feedback that you can apply to your work. So I'm looking forward to taking my 3rd class here starting up in July of this year.
Hi, I'm Jacob Carlson. I'm from Novi High School, and I'm going to be attending Savannah College of Art and Design this fall.
My name is Brennan Eagle. I went to Notre Dame Preparatory High School, and I will be attending College of Creative Studies in the fall.
Hi, my name is Tara Krasinski. I went to Lake Orion High School, and I will be attending Columbus College of Art and Design in the fall.
Hi, my name is Mia Van Ham. I went to Hazel Park High School, and I'll be attending CCS in the fall.
Hi, I'm Hai Kyung So, and I go to Troy High School, or went to Troy High School, and I will be attending School of Visual Arts in the fall.
I've been teaching here since about January of 2015. This piece helped to get me into the Detroit Free Press back in 2014. I had worked down in Shop Play Love, which is in Eastern Market, and a journalist came into the store and asked if I made pottery or made teapots. So I made a teapot, and this got me into the Detroit Free Press. As you see, it has my original logo on the front. It has a D as the handle. The handle has Detroit going down the handle, and if we turn it around, there's the back. It says 313, which is the area code of Detroit, Michigan. The advice I would give to inspiring artists is to keep trying and don't let no stop you from doing what you want to do, and just keep getting your name out there. So keep trying.
This exhibition is one of many that we host throughout the year. You can go to our website, www.pccart.org, for additional information on upcoming events at Paint Creek Center for the Arts.